They don't want to talk about the attack of October 7th on Israel because Biden is no fan of Israel. Any Jewish person that right. votes for Biden does not love Israel. And frankly, it should be spoken to.
Joe Biden is currently in the middle of pursuing political suicide due to his unwavering commitment to Israel. Okay, even though his base overwhelmingly wants a ceasefire in Gaza and wants Biden to leverage the aid that he's providing to Israel, Biden's not listening to them and it's hurting him in the polls. But he's not a friend of Israel. I would venture to say that Biden is more a friend to Israel than to his own base of voters. But according to Donald Trump, not a friend of Israel, Trump believes he'd be a greater friend to Israel. Okay, so what is he gonna send $50 billion to Israel for their war on Gaza?
Well, Anna, to be fair, this is a perfect example of America first policy, where you say, I mean, obviously Israel's first, and America may be second, but it depends on who else is giving money to Donald Trump. No, no, definitely Saudi Arabia second, Russia third. America's gonna be top 10 for sure, for sure. As soon as Donald Trump and his family stop taking bribes from all those other countries. I mean, the Saudis gave Jared Kushner, his son-in-law, $2 billion for a private equity fund. I bet that helped the family, okay? So America third at best, okay? Pausing here to deliver some honest truth as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you. So guys, for all the MAGA guys who are like, oh no, Trump's anti-war. He's saying Biden is not helping the Israelis do more war. And that we should send them more money. Your taxpayer money, you worked super hard for. He's saying they did not kill enough Palestinians. They did not commit enough war crimes. I want them to do more. I'm pro-war more than Biden. And so elect me and I will serve Israel to the best of my abilities. Well, you guys must be so proud.
So this conversation went down on the Wayne Root on Real America's Voice show. And so Trump's on there, he's talking about the ongoing war in Gaza. And he also, of course, was hyper focused on using it as an opportunity to hit at Democrats and Joe Biden specifically. He claims that, you know, Biden isn't completely on Israel's side, it's a shame. And again, that's despite the fact that Biden has been sending more and more military weaponry and funding to Israel, even going around Congress to do so. So let's hear more of what Trump has to say.
How a Jewish person can vote for Biden is, or a Democrat, because they are on the side 100% of the Palestinians, and he doesn't know how to get out of it. He's stuck. But he is, if you look at what he's done, he is totally on the side of the Palestinians. And frankly, it's incredible that historically Jewish people vote for Democrats. To me, I cannot, and I know you're Jewish, Wayne, and I know you vote for me, but I don't understand it, and you probably don't understand it either. I've been more pro-Israel than any other president by far. You know, it's just an amazing thing. Maybe it's just a bad habit when you vote for a Democrat, but I don't know how anybody that's Jewish can vote for a Democrat.
Is there maybe a possibility that Jewish Americans prioritize other domestic policies over Israel? There is a possibility that that's the case.
Yeah.
Okay, so like the idea that the only thing that Jewish American voters are fueled by is Israel is ridiculous. But you know, according to Trump, if you're a Jewish American who supports Biden, who by the way continues to send 2,000 pound bombs to Israel, well then are you really a good Jewish person, right? Are you really someone who loves Israel? It looks like you're a traitor to your identity according to Donald Trump. You must vote for him because he would do more for Israel.
So look, I said I've been saying for a long time now that Joe Biden's gonna lose this election. He's losing the swing states, yada yada, right? But my only caveat was, unless Donald Trump finds a way to, you know, defeat himself, and he's really good at that. He's such a natural born loser that he always finds a different way to punch himself in the face. And this is a prime example of it. So he's got Biden on the ropes. He's now has a, in the last poll, Trump has a 2-point lead with younger voters, which
that's
is
insane.
Shocking.
Yep.
Unbelievable. It's like, If you don't know American politics, younger voters have been voting for Democrats in large numbers, overwhelming numbers for a long time now. Okay, so and Biden last time had over a 20-point lead with younger voters, and it helped decide the election in his favor. So here comes Trump to rescue defeat from the jaws of victory. So what do young voters care about the most, according to the polling? And bless their hearts for being wonderful, decent, caring people. Not student debt relief, not any of the things that you would imagine. They care about Gaza the most. Okay, and that is why Biden has lost their support.
Can I jump?
So here comes Trump. One second, Anna. Here comes Trump. He's like, hey, younger voters, remember, don't vote for me. I'm much worse on Israel than Joe Biden is. I don't care about any innocent Palestinian lives. I don't think Israel's been killing enough. So young voters, make sure you go to Biden. Even though he's financed this genocide, I swear to you guys, I'm gonna be worse. Okay, well now what are we gonna do?
So when we think of young voters, we typically think of individuals who lean more liberal, have more progressive political values. And so that's why it's so shocking that you see some of the more recent polls showing that Trump has actually increased his support among young voters. But let's just forget about that group, that demographic specifically, and just focus on Trump's base. I was very curious to see how Trump was gonna handle Gaza, because the America First crowd, to their credit, are genuine about America First. They don't wanna send more foreign aid to all sorts of countries, but they're not on board with sending more military aid and more resources to Israel. And here you have Donald Trump on a conservative radio show, which by the way, Wayne Root is, he used to be Jewish, he's now evangelical. And he's even more zealous when it comes to his pro-Israel stance. You can guess, I mean, it's shocking to me that he is, that he's switched over to evangelical and now he's more, you know.
That's not shocking. Evangelical Christians are way bigger zealots when it comes to Israel than Jewish Americans.
I know, and the reason why is what grosses me out, considering he was Jewish. So he, anyway, let's get off that topic. But what does he do? Like, I thought Trump might actually, because look, you can hate him all you want, and I don't agree with Trump's policies. We've been very critical of Trump. But one thing I've given him credit for is the fact that he seems to have good political instincts, right? He seems to play to his base, whereas, you know, with the Democratic Party, it's a freaking struggle to get Democratic candidates and Democratic presidential candidates to listen to the base. With Trump, that's not been the case. But in this particular issue, Trump's having difficulty, because on one hand, you have the Adelsons, you've got that sweet, sweet campaign cash. But then on the other hand, you know, you've got the America First MAGA crowd. Which one do you choose? He needs the money, he's had some difficulty fundraising, but he also needs to play to his base. And this interview made it clear which strategy he's gonna take. He's gonna go straight for the pro-Israel stance because he needs that campaign cash.
Okay. So guys, you can check it out for yourself. If you're MAGA, you don't believe us, that's okay. Look it up online. And so Sheldon Adelson gave Trump $100 million in 2016, and then again, another $100 million in 2020. And that's why he moved the embassy, that's why he did everything that Israel asked for. So if you're like a right-wing zealot, and there's some of them still exist, right-wing zealots that are for Israel, so because they're evangelical Christians and hope that everybody in Israel dies, Jews, Muslims, everybody, when Jesus comes back after they start Armageddon and all that nonsense, okay, you're gonna stay in Trump's side and you're gonna be Republican supporter of Israel, no problem. I understand it, I think it's monstrous. I think you guys are the worst people on earth, but at least I get your motivations, right? But if you're anti-war MAGA, there's no question Trump is choosing Miriam Adelson, who's the widow of Sheldon Adelson, over you. He's saying, I would rather try to get another $100 million in legalized bribes from her, because it's all about me. And you thought I was anti-war? No, I'm more pro-war than Joe Biden. I don't think there's been enough war here in the Middle East. By the way, remember, he moved the embassy, which could have started another war. He killed the top Iranian general, which could have started another war. So he's been he got out of the Iranian deal, which was a peace deal. He's been agitating and agitating for more war. And now he says, I swear if I'm elected, I will serve Israel obediently. Okay, and my donors basically in this case. So MAGA, what is it? No, he's wrong on this and you know it. So that's them. You could lie to yourself if you want and come up with excuses. But at the end of the day, I think Anna's right. What I'm seeing in social media is a lot of America First MAGA guys going, This isn't what I signed up for. This is weird. Why is he doing this? I got news for you. It's very obvious. He's doing it for the same reason every politician does it. Corruption. Okay, last thing. Because not only is this an ad to repel younger voters, to hurt his own base, but it is, of course, as Anna mentioned, also a classic anti-Semitic trope to say that Jews don't care about America, even if they're American citizens. They care about Israel first, and then their loyalty to Israel first. It's so ironic because Trump is swearing my loyalty is to Israel first, while pretending Jewish Americans are saying it, right? Well, they never said that. 70% of Jewish Americans voted for Joe Biden. So what he just did was he spit in the face of 70% of Jews in this country, saying you guys aren't real Jews. You think that's a good political strategy? No, that's a terrible political strategy. So 3 for 3 on how this was awful politics and awful policy. So there you go. Joe Biden gets back in the race by Donald Trump punching himself in the face 200 times. Because that's what losers do. And that's what he's in the middle of doing right now.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.